by the PC TV Network, powered by TELUS Vision, your hometown station. We're home for you.
It's Earth's Little Heaven, the PC TV Network. PC TV Network, your hometown station. We're home for you. That's our slogan. But I dare adjust, and it's the truth, and it fits best. The PC TV Network, your number one source for local sports, with your favorite host, Bernie, Dave, Al, and Scott. The PC TV Network, we're home for you. It's more than a slogan, it's all true. Local programming, stream 24/7. The PC TV Network, it's Earth's Little Heaven. The PC TV Network, check out channels 22, 28, and 98. Tune in, it's sure to be great. The PCTVNetwork.com, uh-huh. The PCTVNetwork.com, uh-huh. The PCTVNetwork.com, uh-huh. Make sure you support PCTV Network, PCTVNetwork.com. Your hometown station.
From Ram Stadium on the campus of Springford High School, the PCTV Network proudly presents the 2019 PAC Baseball Championship, featuring the Springford Rams versus the Phantoms of Phoenixville. Hello, everyone. I'm Bernie Gallagher, joined by my partner, Richie Ashburn, Jr. Welcome to the Sircon pre-game show, sponsored by NFL referee James Coleman. Break it down, Rich. First, we'll look at the Phoenixville Phantoms, led by first-year head coach Dave Semina. They come in as the number two seed overall, and last night they were on the brink of elimination in the bottom of the last inning, only to win by way of heroic walk-off.
Yeah, you can't do it any better than the way Justin Blakey did it. A two-run single to win the game, a walk-off. Just a fabulous way to be in the semifinals and win to get here. And number two with Springford, 9-2 shellacking of Methacton, and Griffin pitching for Methacton, maybe the best pitcher in the league. Got to give Springford credit. They both got here, you know, in fashion.
Two exciting semifinals only 22 hours ago. Rich, let's look a little more closely again at Phoenixville, the prohibitive underdog, despite being the two seed, coming from the small school Frontier Division, playing the large school Liberty Division Springford. And you had a chance to visit with Coach Semina before the game.
I did, and we chatted a little bit about his late coming to the season, what a good job he's been doing. That was my saying, not his, but. He's got some exciting young players. A pitcher tonight, the freshman Kingsbury. How often do you have a freshman starting a championship game? And their catcher, Geiger, he's a sophomore. So this is an up-and-coming team still. They're here tonight to show what they got.
And then you look at the Springford roster, their first four hitters in that lineup. It's a virtual all-star team.
It is. I've talked with the coach before the game also, Jamie, and he... I usually ask about one or two, but he had four of them for me, and it was McCurry, McNally, Simmons, and Wolchecki. Right. Those are the ones you got to watch out for. They've been a hot team all year, top four hitters, and they're ready tonight.
And last thought, Rich, keys to the game. Neither of these teams hit a lot of home runs. How does that narrow in on your key to the game?
Well, Phoenixville, to start with them, I think it's got to be small ball. We had talked about it, and neither of these teams are really home run hitting teams. I think maybe three total between them. But I think for Phoenixville, it is small ball, and they got here for probably on their pitching and defense too. So if they do all three of those, they're probably in pretty good shape. Springford, what do you say? They got Hunter Curley, last night's hero, had double with the bases loaded. He was the offensive hero. And he's got to be the pitching guy. I think tonight we have Mail was last night. So and they were moved up because of an injury. So the number three became two, and two became one, basically. So
there is a buzz in the air. In about 2 hours' time, we will crown a new champion. Don't touch that remote. We'll be right back with all the action.
We'll be right back. So I want to take this opportunity just to let you know that Chestnut Knoll at Home has two offices, one in Phoenixville and one in Gilbertsville. We offer part-time and full-time positions. We have a 401k program that goes into effect 1 year after your employment. We also offer paid time off. We offer flexibility of hours. And the fact that you're out there making a difference in someone's life.
The feeling that they matter in this world, especially the elderly. I think they're so overlooked sometimes. And if they don't have family members, and you might be the only person that touched their life that day with a smile.
Flexibility is great because I'm a college student. I'm meant to be an RN, and they work around my schedule really well. I give them enough time to when it's going to change, and they put in for me. I have no problems. And that's a great aspect to the company as well.
Single mom, so I could still see their sports, still be there for dinner, still be around on the weekends, still pick up a couple hours here and there, but ultimately ended up just making this is what I was supposed to do, work in home care.
This is the year you're going to improve your game. No excuses. And the pros at Blackwood Golf Academy are here to help. With their 23-acre all-grass driving range, full-service pro shop, and computerized swing analysis, Blackwood Golf Academy will get your game up to par. Need lessons? Individual and group instruction with head pro Chris Carr will shave strokes off your game and make you the envy of your next foursome. Blackwood Golf Academy, a country club setting open to the public, adjacent to Blackwood Golf Course in Douglasville.
Welcome to the beautiful historic Redding Country Club, now open to the public. Play the same course that Sneed, Hogan, and Hagen played. Designed back in 1923 by renowned golf architect Alex Finlay, the Redding has 18 championship holes. Now, after your round, just stop on by the Patio Grill for delicious food and a nice ice-cold beverage. Why not book your organization's next outing at the Redding Country Club? Hey, and by the way, check out the weekly exciting leagues. It's memorable now at the Redding. For more information, just check out the website, reddingccgolf.com.
One day these rats were playing in the woods.
What if some matches and that's no good?
Meow! Don't play with matches. Don't play with fire.
Fire!
Sort of gorgeous force. It's what you desire. Don't play with matches.
Don't play with fire.
Only you can prevent forest fires.
Fire!
For more than 50 years, Pottstown Oral and Maxillofacial Surgery has served its community with expert dental care, offering patients dental implants and a full menu of procedures for many types of dental problems, including bone grafting, wisdom teeth, impacted canines, facial trauma, jaw surgery, oral pathology, TMJ disorders, and sleep apnea. Get the smile you've always wanted. Contact Pottstown Oral and Maxillofacial Surgery today.
Hey, Terry Musser here. Doing whatever it takes as always. People ask me, can I still do a cartwheel? I can. But when we work with you, we're not only going to do cartwheels, we're going to bend over backwards.
Hey, welcome back, everyone. It is the 2019 Baseball Championship for the Pioneer Athletic Conference. I'm your play-by-play announcer, Bernie Gallagher, here with our color commentator, Richie Ashburn, Jr., Gus Tellis, the entire PCTV Network crew out here way early, and the home team on what is actually Spring Ford's home field will be the Phoenixville Phantoms in their purple and gray. They take the field on what was a sun-splashed afternoon. Richie, the weather is ideal. 73 degrees at game time.
This is what my dad would have ordered up. This is a beautiful night for baseball. Love being here for this championship game, man.
about an 8 mile per hour wind blowing out towards 422, which is left center. And boy, a thrilling semifinal for Phoenixville last night. Rich, as you stated in the opening, Blakey with every player's dream, a walk-off win.
Yeah, I remember that the rest of his life. I mean, I remember base hits in Little League that I thought were big, but you know, when you get to high school and win games like that, what a great memory for that young man.
And also, Rich, I want to get into your head a little bit. Conspicuous by their absence from the Final Four, defending champion Boyertown.
Well, yeah, I think you'd have to question almost every year why they're not here. You know, they're always one of the perennial teams in this league and any league they've ever been in. They're just fantastic baseball up there. But you know, you got to have a down year sometime.
What? Not in Boyertown. No way. Boyertown, the state champion of 3 years ago, and this team that you're going to see in white, the Spring Ford Rams, everyone looked last summer, the boys of summer, the Spring City American Legion won the Pennsylvania state title.
I mean, there's another dream right there. this area, this league is just filled with talent, and I think we're going to see a lot of it tonight. Some good young talent here tonight we're going to get a look at.
Yeah, to the casual observer, if you want to know what this region, call it the southeast region of the state, is noted for, one of the things is baseball. A year after year, we see state champions at the scholastic level and also during the summer American Legion and the senior Babe Ruth. Leading off for Springfort, number 5, the senior right fielder, Ben Wilczacki. Wilczacki has been an on-base machine this year. And you've got, Rich, as you talked about a little bit, both teams have thrown their aces, so we may see some offense tonight.
Yeah, I'm kind of hoping. You know, you're always talking about pitching and defense. Let's see a little hit.
I like it. The ball should travel well. They are the optimal conditions for traveling. You have about, like I said, 73 degrees at game time. Not much of a wind to knock anything down. So we should see some good travel. It takes a poke to get it out of here. It's 365 in the power alley.
It'll cool down a little bit, too. Ball won't travel as well, but you're right. There is no wind, and right now it should travel.
Two balls, one strike to the leadoff hitter. Count runs to 3-1. We talked about Boyertown, and Boyertown, 3-1's a take. 3-2 might be a take.
Babe Ruth on that team to get a take sign.
Wilczacki with a 357 batting average on the year. And he gets a base on balls to open things up, and that'll bring to the plate number 7, the senior center fielder, Chase Simmons.
And you don't want to be walking these guys. Talking to the coach before the game, you know, this is a team he thinks has more team speed than, you know, any team he's ever coached at this level. So I think we're looking for Springford to use that.
Simmons with a 311 batting average and an on-base percentage of 391. Springford lineup senior laden. Off and running, attempted steal, throw down to second, safe with a stolen base.
Wilczacki made that look easy. He got a nice jump. And I think about three quarters of the way down there, he was jogging down there. He knew he had it stolen. Get a look at this burn. The catcher, I don't think he had a chance. He was kind of, you see him sliding there, but he had slowed down about three quarters of the way there. He knew he had it.
Breaking ball misses the zone, in the opinion of the man in blue.
Is there any other opinion?
Well, you know, soon they'll be replaying balls and strikes the way it's going.
Oh, I know.
Swing and a miss.
Off-speed fastball or something?
Kazem.
Got a great crew tonight. We're getting these replays right away. I think this is an off-speed fastball, Bernie. He had a nice stroke on that, too, but he was way ahead of it.
Yeah, it looked like he went two-seamer instead of four-seam. Bringing to the plate number two, the shortstop, Mark McNelly. 311 batting average, a 391 on base percentage. Calling a pretty tight zone early on. Thank you. Both these teams compete in the 6A division, which is the largest in the state of Pennsylvania. There's a ball popped to the right side. Right fielder with a nice play, O'Donnell, and the runner will advance to third. O'Donnell appeared to have lost that ball initially, but relocated. That'll bring to the plate number six, the senior left fielder, David McCurry.
He's got a little bit of sun there in his...
McCurry, a 311 batting average, 354 on base percentage. There's a ball stroke to the left side, and a nice catch by Fink in left field to retire the side. After one half inning, it's zip, zip.
An orthopedic institute is more than a name. It's a unique care model based on quality and compassion. Decades devoted to research and clinical trials, the development of new surgical techniques, and physicians who outperform the field. What you get from our institute is more options and more answers. For your orthopedic care, think Rothman first.
New office and 7-day urgent care now open in Limerick.
We're back, and we want to extend our sincerest thanks to Cheese Melt at the Coventry Mall in the food court for providing delicious food to our crew before the game. If you haven't been over there, Gary Coppola, they do a wonderful job. A wide variety on their menu, and those home-baked fries go just about with any sandwich they make.
Ooh, sounds good.
I buy the sandwiches just to get the home-baked fries. Our chips, I mean, home-baked chips.
Food and baseball have always gone well together, Bernie.
So as I indicated, this is the largest division. District plays coming right around the corner. And, you know, we talked about Boyertown in the league, but either of these teams, well, actually, Phoenixville's in a 5A. Springford could meet Boyertown again in districts.
It's not like they don't see each other. Districts or wherever, they seem to play each other quite a bit over the years.
There were a lot of people before the game asking me why this game wasn't played at a neutral field. Boyertown, perhaps the finest amateur facility in the country, you would think would have been available for a championship game.
Yeah, and I know they pick these well ahead of time, I guess, if there was an emergency or rain or field being used for another reason, they would do that. But I remember, you know, they picked these couple ballparks to be always the championship sites.
Okay.
Years ago when I was coaching, and nobody really complained because the fields were the best in the league.
Leading off for Phoenixville, number 14, the shortstop, Colton Brown. Been an on-base machine this year, hitting close to 300, 429 on base.
Wow. That's what you want at the top.
One ball, one strike to the leadoff hitter. Last year's semifinal, Phoenixville defeated Methacton. Boyertown defeated Springford. And then Boyertown defeated Phoenixville for the championship. Looking for the mascot. Where's the fanatic? Can we get Gritty out here? Anybody, you know? There's a ball skied into the deep infield. And second baseman... Kratz with a good call for out number one. Number 22, the senior center fielder, Tripp Shoemaker. brings in a hefty .339 batting average into tonight's contest. Breaking ball in for a strike. Familiar name, Shoemaker.
Yeah, absolutely. I know a few of them, Byrne.
Well, correct me if I'm wrong. There's a ground ball to third base side. Collins fires a BB over to first for the out. Smiley on the receiving end. Nice it Steve Shoemaker was the star pitcher for Phoenixville maybe 15, 20 years ago. And Creighton Gubonic was the catcher. Gubonic, his claim to fame, his first at-bat in the major leagues for the Red Sox, hit a grand slam.
You know, he should have quit. He should have quit right after that.
I would have retired right then and there. One at-bat, four RBIs. Welcome to the major leagues.
Well, he had a couple years in the majors, I know.
Yeah,
that.
He did.
Deserved to be there, obviously. And I'm teasing when I say he should have quit after that. But, you know, you hit a grand slam, your first major league at-bat.
Ethan O'Donnell with a ground ball, and it's fair ball. He's going to get a single out of it. Good movement by the left fielder McCurry to prevent the double. O'Connell.
I'm sorry, Byrne. That is a base hit. It hit the cutout right before it got to the third baseman and stayed down. He just didn't want down far enough.
O'Connell, the gentleman who just singled, carried a .417 average up to the plate. That'll bring up the cleanup hitter, number 35, first baseman Dylan Clark. He looks like a cleanup hitter, doesn't he?
Sounds like a cleanup hitter. Dylan Clark. Yeah, he's a big, strong lefty. Like that.
He turns on a ground ball, second base. Kratz over to Smiley for out number three. After one, we're in a scoreless tie.
Limerick Bowl is the area's ultimate family entertainment center. Your league bowling headquarters for all ages and all abilities. Come in anytime and enjoy daily specials or experience our weekend glow bowling. Celebrate your next birthday at Limerick Bowl with the area's most affordable party packages. Now including our newly renovated Family Fun Arcade. Limerick Bowl on West Ridge Pike. Get more information about upcoming leagues, tournaments, and open bowling specials online at limerickbowl.com.
We're back. We go to the top of the second inning. Number 11, Hunter Curley, the hero from last night's semifinal. In a tight game, he got up with the bases loaded and tripled.
Amazing. I think they gave him a double in the paper, but it doesn't matter. He cleared the bases. And that's awesome. Offensive hero and maybe a pitching hero tonight. We'll see.
Breaking ball just wraps around the zone for ball one. I want to thank Mike Engro of Engro Insurance Agency, Allstate Insurance Agency on Lewis Road in Royers Ford, bringing this game into your living room. A gigantic supporter of sports in our area, and his son, the number one quarterback in the area. He got my vote last year for Offensive Player of the Year. 29 touchdowns, 5 interceptions. Watch out for that Spring Ford football team.
Nice.
Ball fouled back. Not going to hit my car. I'm a mile away. I got too many dents on it already.
Yeah, it was too far for me to park. That back where you park.
Man, he is calling a tight zone. We're going to be here till midnight.
That's all right.
You know, when I umpired, which was not one of my most fun experiences in life, I let everybody know before the game, hey, anything close to the strike, swing the bats.
Well, you're going to give those swing. They don't. I used to do that at the smaller levels with the younger kids.
Full count, no one out, top of two. It is the championship. Strike three looking. The young freshman, ice water in his veins.
First baseman, number 8, Jason Smiley.
too close to take.
Yeah, absolutely. First baseman Jason Smiley, number 8, a senior. Hitting close to 300, a 390 on base percentage. It's got to be from that baseball family, the Scott Smiley family.
He's got to be.
His older brother, I'm guessing, is the star closer now for Immaculata College. We saw him here on the PCTV network playing football and baseball. There's a ball lifted foul down the left field line into the bullpen. We got to get to at least one story about your dad every time I do a game with you.
I got plenty of them.
People forget some of the nuances that made him famous. There's another foul ball down in near the bullpen. What was his opinion on sacrifice bunts?
He was not big on sacrificing, giving up outs. He was there to bunt for hits, and he felt, I mean, there were times and places for sack bunts, obviously, depending on the situation.
Not too many from the games I watched.
No. No, he did not like giving up.
He's going to let you know when he doesn't like something.
Oh, he always did. Always did.
I watched a documentary on your father, the Hall of Famer Richie Ashburn, and I just Googled it up on YouTube, kind of, and people forget the tenacity that he played with. Back in the day, I don't want to say, what's the word to describe, super aggressive?
I always described him as, and I only saw him play, I was 3 when he retired, but all the films, everything I've ever seen, saw him play tennis. He was fierce.
Yeah.
He was a fierce competitor.
Yep, absolutely.
And he just wanted things to be fair because he had such a good eye at the plate. The umpires didn't like calling him out because they knew they were going to get it.
That's a swing and a miss. Strike 3, the freshman showing maturity beyond his years.
Yeah, he's throwing hard and a nice pitch. A little high. He shouldn't be reaching for that. But, hey, guess what? When you got the count with you. He's showing some nice poise. Starting to rack up some strikeouts here, too.
Number 14, Zach Kratz steps into the batter's box. Junior second baseman, 267 average on the year with a 313 on base percentage. Yeah, one of the highlights of your dad was going in the second base, metal spikes up in the air. Like, get out the way or you're going to get spiked.
Yeah, exactly. Well, they played that way back then. And he wasn't really out to hurt anybody. Nice catch there by a catcher.
Geiger with a good catch behind home plate for out number 3. We'll go to the bottom of the second. You're watching this game on the PCTV Network. Yakalak Construction, serving the Tri-County area since 1946. Family-owned. Free estimates, all types of concrete work, sidewalks, foundations, steps, curbs, and more. Professional service and quality. Give them a call, 610-323-8134. Hey, welcome back, everyone. We go to the bottom of the second inning, and we are pleased to have a guest in the broadcast booth with us as we get a ground ball to shortstop. And Springford shortstop Collins over to Smiley for out number 1. And we want to welcome Kathy Williams into our booth. You are the music teacher at Pottsgrove. And tell me a little bit about, there's a lot of buzz, excitement about the Pottsgrove Community Band.
Yes, we have our 60th anniversary concert coming up on June 9th at 2 o'clock in Pottsgrove High School Auditorium. And it's not only an anniversary concert, but it's in memory of our founder and high school band director, Mr. Tom Roberts, who passed away this year. And we're 60 years old, and it's thanks to him he started it.
Meanwhile, number 5, the hero of last night's game, Blakey, and he gets hit by a pitch. He'll go to first base. On the previous batter, Dylan Clark was out. Take a look. Here's a bean ball. Boy, up near that left shoulder, up near the face. He's fortunate to get out of the way. That'll put a runner on first base and bring, looks like number 17, left fielder Brandon Fink will step in. Kathy, let's get back to that. How did the band get started?
Well, community bands aren't new to Pottstown. Pottstown had a community band way back in the early 1900s with the Pottstown Band. My dad, actually, Bill Lamb, conducted it in 1935.
Wow.
Into the 1960s, and then Arlen Saylor took it over.
Oh, I know him.
Yeah. My dad started Arlen on his trumpet.
Really?
And Arlen was a soloist with the band when he was 9 years old. So community bands aren't new to the Pottstown area, but Mr. Roberts started teaching at Pottsgrove in 1959 and wanted to have his own community band made up of adults and students when it first started. And the first concert was in 1960.
Wow. Blakey, meanwhile, with a smooth steal of second base. However, the umpire is interceding, and we could have a call behind the plate. This Phoenixville coach not happy. Perhaps it is a batter interference. We don't know, but the runner has returned to first base. And they're having a discussion while they talk that over, Kathy. Who are some of the members of the band?
Well, the members of the band are a lot of community members from the area, barbers, doctors, retired music teachers, anyone who plays an instrument. There's no auditions. We don't have a talent requirement. Whoever likes to play and misses playing their instrument is welcome to join.
Anybody can audition?
No, we don't even audition.
Let's take a look at this play, and we'll get back to Kathy. They may have called interference. The runner had to return to first base. Okay, they're going to say after his follow-through, he stepped in front of the catcher, so that will negate the stolen base. So I play a little bass guitar. I'm no good, but I love it. Can I audition?
You don't need to audition. We take anybody.
Oh, wow. Okay.
But I'm not sure bass guitar is all right. Can you play an upright bass?
No, I haven't tried that.
Well, we'll have to teach you.
Dylan Kramer, number 24, the third baseman at the plate. Where and when do you do your rehearsals?
We rehearse every Monday night at Pottsgrove High School in the band room from September to about the middle of November. And then we do Christmas concerts. Then we start up again in January and rehearse until
ball ripped to right field. Blakey, he's gonna go all the way for first base. He's gonna try the score. He's in there. He's safe. Oh my, that kid can fly on a single. He scored from first base. Now he was off and running, stealing second base. You talk about wheels. The ball ripped into the right center field gap. Simmons, a very good center fielder, cuts it off in the alley. They come up throwing, they hit the cut. There's no hesitation. Blakey just puts on the afterburners, and Phoenixville takes a 1-0 lead. Now batting number 15, the catcher, Justin Geiger. And then, Kathy, finally tell me a little bit about the 60th anniversary concert.
Well, we have a lot of soloists, trumpet soloists, saxophone soloists. We play marches, Broadway tunes. There's some John Williams,
wow,
some movie tunes. It's a nice repertoire of band music, and it's something for everybody that they would enjoy.
Wow, and how do I contact you if I would like to join?
You just come on Monday night at 7 o'clock.
At Pottsgrove High School. What entrance?
The sports entrance, the auditorium gym entrance.
Around behind in the back there.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
I'm glad I found that out. Now, I'm not any good, but you might see me there, okay?
Well, we're short of drummers. We may put you on bass
drum.
Oh,
I'll try anything. I just want to have fun, but I'm not any good. But thank you so much for joining us.
God bless you.
What a wonderful thing. You're welcome. Have a great night. Thank you. And you can see Geiger, the runner on first, two down. Phoenixville up 1-0 in the championship game. He thought he had a base on balls. Not going to happen. Curley wants to, got a full count, wants to keep it at one. I always was a proponent of throwing over a 3-2 count, two down. You know he's running.
Yeah. You can catch him a lot, too.
Ball high. That'll put a runner in scoring position. And that'll turn the lineup over. How about Blakey scoring from first on a single?
This kid's got some speed.
He took advantage of it, too. He wasn't stopping. I think the third base coach could have put up the stop sign. He wasn't stopping. He did not do that, by the way.
And they're going to have a little talk. We get a temporary timeout on the field. You know, Phoenixville, what a history of baseball. Piazza, Andre Thornton, Doc Kennedy, Gubanek. I mean, the names go on. A proud tradition down there.
Like you said, there's four or five guys that, you know, were real good major leaguers, and some of them Hall of Famers. And some of them are coaching Hall of Famers, if you ask me. It's amazing. A small little town like Phoenixville to come up with talent like that, that's just incredible.
Yeah, Piazza recognized as the greatest hitting catcher of all time.
Yeah, I agree.
And that says a lot, because Johnny Bench could hit a ball.
Oh, yeah.
You know, he had over 500 home runs, but I think Piazza had obviously a higher average.
Right, and you can compare them offensively. Defensively, I think Bench by far, but I'll take Piazza.
Number 14, Colton Brown, leadoff hitters up. Got runners on first and second, two out. Curley, the pitcher for Springford in white, trying to keep it at a 1-0 game. These Springford coaches love to wear the gold numbers on the white shirts for the announcers. There's a ground. What a stop down there. They're not going to get an out, but that's going to save a run. Collins, the third baseman from Springford, showing great reaction time.
Terrific play. You're right. It would have been an easy run in, too, because good jump from second base. And he made a nice job there. Now they got a chance to at least, you know, get a force or turn a double play. So he just kept them in the game right there.
Bases are loaded. Two out. Bottom of two. Phoenixville in purple with a chance to get some runs here. Number 22, senior center fielder Tripp Shoemaker, a .339 hitter at the dish. We have one kid from our area making some noise. Remember A.J. Bogucki, the pitcher from Boyertown?
Yeah,
he's pitching for the Nats in the minor leagues for the Potomac Nats. He was a setup man for North Carolina for 3 years. Richie, let's take a look at the replay. Collins with an outstanding play.
He's doing what you're supposed to do. Down. Gets to his right real nice. Knocks it down. You can see where the runner is. He's going to score on anything that's knocked down. Nice coverage.
That'll save a run for Curley and the Rams. Both these teams will be going on to district playoffs. We'll talk more about that as the game goes on. So Shoemaker fouls it to the right side. We had a no-hitter thrown recently we want to talk about. There's a ball poked into the outfield. Looks like it'd be a routine can of corn. Simmons for the third out of the inning. Curley does well to keep it at one run. After two innings, Phoenixville 1 and Springford 0.
When did you see the sign?
When I needed to jumpstart sales.
Build attendance for an event.
Help people find their way. Fast Signs designed new directional signage.
And got them back on track. Get started at fastsigns.com.
Welcome back. We are pleased to be joined in the broadcast booth. Jill Walker, there's the camera over there. Turn and say hello to our fans out there. You do such a tremendous job. Positive energy. We did the Potts Grove Norristown basketball game together. You're going Facebook Live, a little bit of social media here.
You got to these days, right? For all businesses. So getting a good presence on the social media networks is huge. And we're starting to cover a lot more events, and we're anxious to cover other people's events too. So a lot of good stuff going on out there. So from baseball to proms, everything. And it's nice to really dig deep into the community and show people what's going on.
Well, you're touching the lives of young people after you visited Potts Grove for that basketball game, and we'll interject here just with the at bat for Springford now. Number 25 will step in. And let's check our roster here. That's the sophomore DH, Jack Casella. And he ground ball to shortstop. Brown over to Clark. Clark digs it out for out number one. Nice play. But getting back to that, several of the cheerleaders, the basketball players, they say, who was that lady that was here, put us on Facebook Live?
It's awesome for the young folks nowadays, too. They can be seen, you know, and it's awesome opportunity, so it's great. These guys are great to be up this close to. They're so big and strong these days. A lot of good players.
We'll take a look at the replay. Look at the stellar defensive play over there by Clark, and that's a bang-bang play at first base. And now batting for Springford, number 16, the third baseman, Matt Collins. Speaking of stellar defensive plays, ground ball first base. Clark will go unassisted for out number two. So bring us up to speed on the PCTV Facebook page. Like, what's going on? How can we get involved in that kind
of
thing?
Absolutely. So it's not just Facebook now. We're on Instagram as well. And they have their YouTube channel. So there's a lot of opportunities now through different segments to be seen. So we're anxious to get out with more businesses and showcase and also events and so forth in the area and showcase their business and let everybody know what's going on.
Meanwhile, number five, Ben Wilczacki, steps up for Springford with two down. So all I got to do is go, say, on Facebook or Twitter or Instagram and search PCTV Network.
The PCTV Network.
Okay.
Yep, you got it.
And we can hook up and we can message Jill.
You can message us, absolutely. We'll come cover your events, and it'll be great.
I might have to send you a message after the game.
Sounds good.
Jill Walker, we love the job you do. We love your positive energy.
Thank you, Bernie.
All right, see you later.
Yep.
So meanwhile, Wilczacki is now on first base, showing good wheels down the first baseline. And that'll bring number seven, the dangerous Chase Simmons, center fielder. With two down, runner on first, Rams down one. Back Richie Ashburn, our color guy, back in the booth. Rich, you always do the field analysis. What's your tonight's take on the field after all that rain we had?
Did it rain? It's beautiful. These fields, I know, are made to absorb water, and the engineering, everything that goes into this, and the dedication by the ground crew here and the school, it's amazing.
Now, your buddies down there at Walsh's Golf Farm, I believe, are in charge of the turf here, right?
They are consultants, I believe, and Butch or Ray Jr. comes here, and he's Penn State agriculture guy, so knows what he's talking about. And yes, they are partly responsible for how this field looks.
325 down the lines, 365 in the power alleys, a good lighting system. Thanks to Mickey McDaniel and the Springford people for making us feel welcome. There's a stolen base. Nice job there by Wilczacki.
Throw down a little bit, doesn't help the catcher. Nice throw by him, though. Almost had him. Good throw, or good pitch, probably would have.
So Springford with an opportunity to tie this baby up. Two down, 2-1 count, and the dangerous Simmons. 3-1, hitter's count.
Well, these guys are, they're top of this lineup is kids that can hit. So they've done the job. He's in scoring position. Let's try to get him home.
Ball four. Phoenixville doing all this without the MVP from last year, Kevin Cushing, now off in college. And talk about another dangerous hitter, Mark McNally, the senior shortstop number two. 311 average, 391 on base, 12 RBIs, two doubles, four triples, and one homer.
That's the, he's the power guy on this team.
That equates, Rich, to a 525 slugging percentage.
Wow. I don't know if I ever had that.
I don't know, you could swing a bat pretty good.
I never knew what my slugging percentage was. I knew what my batting average was, but I never knew what my slugging percentage was.
You were kind of a gapper, a lot of doubles.
Yeah, it was. And pitchers didn't know how to throw to lefties.
Yeah.
He hit us all the time.
Your dad, of course, with a lifetime 308 average. That'll get you in the Hall of Fame. Swing and a miss for strike one. I even found you on YouTube.
Did you?
I searched Richie Ashburn Jr. You were at some ball field dedicating something to Dick Allen.
Oh, that was, down by the ballpark. It's Richie Ashburn Field.
A double steal for the Rams.
Love that.
Simmons takes second. Wilczeki takes third.
Down a run. It's early in the game, but not many coaches would do this. They take advantage of this. Nice job. Not even close.
Ball popped to the right side. The right fielder, O'Donnell, calls for it. That's actually Blakey out there in right. That'll be out number three. And the Phantoms hold on to their advantage, 1-0.
Butter Valley Golf Course. Conveniently located in the quiet, rural setting of Valley, PA, just off Route 100. One of the nicest, most affordable 18-hole course in the region. With changing elevations, challenging greens, and scenic fairways, golfers of all ability levels are sure to enjoy their round. Butter Valley Golf Course is a great place to enjoy the game of golf with friends or family, young and old alike. Grab some buddies and grab a meal at the Runway Grill before or after your round. Butter Valley Golf Course.
There once was a haunted house. People said they had heard voices, but no one dared to go inside.
There's a place for wood in your backyard. We recommend the fire pit. For looks and performance that outlast a wooden deck, make sure your next deck is built with Trex. Engineering what's next in outdoor living.
Your Trex expert is A.D. Moyer Lumber. ADMoyer.com.
We are back at the beautiful Rams Stadium in Royersford, PA. Richie Ashburn Jr., our color commentator, on Bernie Gallagher, Gus Tellis, the entire PCTV Network crew on hand. And again, we were talking about Angro Insurance. I believe Mike Angro is here tonight. Want to thank him for sponsoring this broadcast as well. All our sponsors, you're interested in putting a 30-second TV commercial on the PCTV Network or running a special 500 commercials in 90 days, message me on Facebook. I'm Bernie Gallagher. I'll bring the coffee and donuts, and we'll make your watch your business grow. There's a ball ripped to deep left field. Back near the wall and off the wall. Number 34, Ethan O'Donnell with a bomb to left field.
Big way to start the inning, Vern. Nice swing. Looks like it's going off the bat. Hits it deep right off the base of the fence, I think.
Dylan Clark steps in, the cleanup hitter. Number 35, the senior first baseman. .458 on base percentage. There's a ball hit. Hard, fair! Down the right field line, that's going to bring a run in. Clark with the RBI single.
First pitch.
2-0, Phoenixville on top.
I was really trying to see how Curley would come out after, you know, struggling last inning and getting away with just one run in that inning. And first two batters come out here for Phoenixville swinging. It's a hit and night, Burn. Well, that was just fair. Makes it home easily there.
Joel Embiid there after scoring the run.
It's a hard run in the book.
There's nobody out. Runner on first. Number 11, Devin Gurrell. Second baseman at the plate. Clark does not look runnerish on first base.
Love that runnerish.
Oh, he's turning his head and looking back at first base. So that's a cardinal rule. There's a line shot, left field in the gap, and the big guy's going to rumble into third base. Drill with a double and a wave to the dugout, Bryce Harper style. These kids are having fun.
They're swinging the bats. Beautiful swings we're seeing here. These last three batters are seeing this pitcher. Maybe time to talk to.
Oh, boy, that's a freight train going into third. Yeah. With the slide, no less.
Welcome to third.
Spring Ford wants to talk about it. Down 2-0. Top of four. Or bottom of three, I'm sorry.
Yeah, bottom three. And and Bernie, they're hitting this guy. He's up there throwing strikes, but they're, you know, he's competing, but right now they're hitting him hard. These type of games, you know, it's only 2-0. The way he's being hit right now, I think you almost have to think about taking him out. And this is a championship game, and I only say that because it is a championship game.
And, Rich, you and I talked before the game. Skoraki, the ace of Spring Ford, is no longer available to pitch for the remainder of the season. That bumps Mail up into the one slot, Curly into the two hole. So he's gonna stay with his two guy.
Well, he's at 34 pitches right now, and they're seeing him. 19 strikes out of 34 pitches.
Oh, boy.
It's tough.
16 balls, not going to get it done. The ball was a little up in the zone that last pitch. And now the hero of last night's game, number 5, Justin Blakey. You know, I meant to ask him before the game, Blakey, a familiar Phoenixville, Pottstown name. They are actually the cousins of Ralph Sampson, the former 7-foot plus center, NBA star athlete who I met actually in Pottstown in a hardware store. I turned the corner. I swear to God, I turned the corner. I'm like, Ralph, what are you doing here? I said, I'm buying some paint. I'm like, hey, man, good to meet you. Yeah. I had to reach up to shake his hand.
Was he painting somebody else's house?
I don't know.
Maybe he lives in the area.
But Blakey got up last night, every player's dream. His team was down 5-4, and he hit a 2-run single to win the semifinal. Now he can do some major damage. Boy, he's got a nice cut.
Yeah, nice short sweep. Swing. He just missed that. As I was just saying, the first three, four batters here, they're seeing this ball. And, you know, I don't know, maybe you keep Curly in the game, someone else comes in just to give him a different look. They're seeing him.
Nasty breaking ball.
As I say that, he throws one of the best pitches of the game.
Two balls, two strikes, no one out. Runners in scoring position. Phoenixville already up 2-0. This is pivotal. Swing and a miss. Strike three. Curly reaches back when he has to.
These last two pitches are probably the best in the game.
Slider.
Very nice job. Yeah, very nice job by this young man. Here, I'm putting him on the bench, and he's showing me wrong. I love it.
Number 17, the left fielder, Brandon Fink, steps in. One down. Ball popped in the air behind third base. Shortstop McNelly with a nice catch. That'll keep both runners on the bag.
These are the moments in the game, Burn, that win it or lose it sometimes. And right now, Phoenixville, get a run here really could hurt. But if Spring Ford could hold this to another, just one, this run only, we still got a ball game.
Dylan Kramer, number 24 at bat. Ball one. Yep, these are the pivotal junctures that you mentioned. Almost hits him.
Close.
Kramer in the 8-hole. 9 RBIs on the year, 8 runs scored, a junior third baseman. D. Reich. Both these coaches doing a great job. Dave Semina in his first year for Springford, the interim coach, for Phoenixville, the interim coach, and the legendary Jamie Scheck. All he does is win championships at both the Scholastic and the Legion level. Jamie Scheck, one of the better coaches you'll see.
I've always liked Jamie when I coached against him. I had great respect for him. Always a pleasant guy. You know, he gets the job done. He'll raise his voice a little bit, but he is an exemplary coach.
And it's a bean ball right between the shoulder blades. Doesn't really hurt that much.
He walked his first at bat. He gets a hit by pitch here. That's how you want to turn away from him, kids.
That's not too bad there. You know, no. You get him on the elbow. That's what I hated, man. Getting hit on that elbow.
Yeah, elbow or knee, shin.
15, number 15, the catcher with the bases loaded, Justin Geiger. Steve Reich won. Geiger, the catcher, a sophomore, has only played four games all year.
And here he is in the championship. Gotta love it.
Man, there's a nervous mom and pop in that stand somewhere. Yeah, that's my boy called up from JV's. Phoenixville, for those of you who may have joined us late in the championship, Phoenixville has a freshman pitcher and a sophomore catcher. And this sophomore, with four games under his belt, is at bat with the bases loaded. Two balls, one strike.
Looks pretty cool up there, too.
Nice to see that American flag on the left sleeve.
Absolutely.
Fouls it off the right side. Good swing by Geiger.
Pivotal pitch right here, Byrne.
Can Curley escape two innings in a row? Ground ball right side at the second baseman. Kratz over to Smiley for out number three, and Curley prevents further damage. We'll take a break with the Phantoms up 2-0.
Hi, I'm Joe, and this is Chris, and many of you know us. And we'd like to welcome you to our new showroom here at 618 North Reading Avenue in Boyertown, where we offer Kohler faucets, Moen faucets as well, vanities, tubs, and many accessories.
Here we have an operating, high-efficiency, Energy Star-rated American Standard furnace combined with a variable-speed AC condenser. Let us install one today to start saving you money throughout the heating and cooling season.
Here at Patriot, we now offer kitchen and bath designs.
So come visit us today at 618 North Reading Avenue or visit our website at www.patriotmp.com.
We are back at the beautiful Rams Stadium, Royersford, PA. Go to the top of the fourth inning. It is the championship game. Now batting for Springford, number six, the left fielder, David McCurry.
All right, Kingsbury's at 42 pitches, Byrne, 23 strikes. He's been tough, though, when he's had to be.
Showing the uncommon poise of a ninth grader. Oh, there's a foul ball right near us, Rich.
I see it. Luckily, it's
I didn't bring
us.
My glove. Meanwhile, action in the bullpen for Springford, number five, Will Chackey, their leadoff hitter, getting loose.
I don't know Curley's pitch count yet, but I guess he's getting up there.
Right, Ground ball. Out number one. Good play over there by Clark.
Yeah, he's throwing a lot of ground balls. He's letting his fielders do the job. Kingsbury's doing a nice job, especially like you said, freshman. Got some poise out there.
Number 11, the pitcher, Hunter Curley. 300 hitter, 400 on base percentage, a senior. And he's hit by pitch.
Looked like old Dave Hollins just kind of took it. That was the elbow you were talking about, Bert.
I'm surprised there's no arguing from Phoenixville. He did not make much of an attempt to get out of the way.
Not much, but I guess he didn't have to. His arm didn't flail out there. He took a little nick off the elbow. But you were just talking about it. That's where you don't want to take a hit. That's where he got hit.
That'll bring up the dangerous Jason Smiley, number 8. Courtesy runner for Springford, number 3, Danny Zoller. We just got a text message from Mickey McDaniel, the athletic director at Springford. There's a freight train just over the hill here. It's called the Springford softball team. In case you haven't heard, they're 20-0, and they are winning in the championship game 2-0 after 3 innings.
Another great program here.
They typically go deep in the playoffs under Tim Hughes. State playoffs.
Yeah.
I believe it was last year, the year before, the Springford softball team, our crew, the PCTV network, went up to, I think it was Parkland High School near Allentown, and Springford was in the state semifinal. Good cut, fouled straight back.
Love that lefty swing. I don't know why, but it always looks better on the left side.
If Bryce Harper could keep his front shoulder down and in like Mike Schmidt wants him to,
yeah,
you know, maybe get better zone coverage.
Good eye.
Also want to welcome another new sponsor, Senior Helpers. They're on High Street in Pottstown. What a tremendous job they do helping senior citizens, whether it's 4 hours a day or 10 hours a day. Just an amazing setup. Just Google them up there. Senior Helpers on High Street in Pottstown. What a well-run outfit.
Always good to know your parents or grandparents are in good hands.
Yep. You know, my mom's getting older, and it's, you know, it's like, what are the options? There's a ball lifted to left field. Nice play out there by Fink for the out.
Well, amazingly, Bernie, this is only 2-0, and really we're one at bat away from a tie ball game if, you know, if someone were to ding one. So this Springford is still in this ball game.
I'm ready for some extra innings. I got nowhere to be. I'm retired, man.
I play baseball. I got to say, I'm probably semi-retired.
They got dogs running around in the outfield out there in left center. Hope that dog can't get under the fence. Out there with Debbie Tellis and our hitter-friendly van with a green tarp over it. Debbie got some biscuits. She could throw them right down to the puppy.
Looks like he's getting some exercise.
That's a good place to take a dog for a walk on a ballpark. Debbie's focused. She doesn't even see the dog. Ground ball, third base. Nice play again by Kramer on the dangerous Kratz. And the score remains Phoenixville 2, Springford 0.
For more than 50 years, Pottstown Oral and Maxillofacial Surgery has served its community with expert dental care, offering patients dental implants and a full menu of procedures for many types of dental problems, including bone grafting, wisdom teeth, impacted canines, facial trauma, jaw surgery, oral pathology, TMJ disorders, and sleep apnea. Get the smile you've always wanted. Contact Pottstown Oral and Maxillofacial Surgery today.
We're back. It's bottom of four of the championship. Phoenixville on top, 2-0. Colton Brown, the leadoff hitter at the plate. There's a ground ball third base. Collins picks it up, fires over to Curley now at first base. Smiley's been moved to right. And we have a new pitcher on the mound for the Rams, the leadoff hitter, Ben Wilczacki.
Yeah, and I think it's a good move. They were catching up with him a little bit. He did battle his way out of that inning, kept his team in the game. Got to give Curley some credit. But I think it's a good move by Jamie to make this move, make a change. Phoenixville is seeing it.
Swing and a miss to number 22, senior center fielder Tripp Shoemaker. Carries a hefty .339 average, a .422 on base percentage, 8 stolen bases, 17 runs scored, and he's got the only homer that Phoenixville has all year.
Wow. You think of these Phoenixville teams, and I've coached against them. There are many guys that could hit home runs.
Oh, you think of some of the – remember that kid Chuck Bechtel? We coached against him about 15 years ago. That's one of the longest balls I ever saw hit at the old Springford baseball field across the street. He hit a ball that was 430 plus.
Wow. That's a lot, especially that long ago. And there were big kids then. But.
And Doc Kennedy, the legendary coach at Phoenixville, he told me the reason Piazza hit to right field was, you remember, they had no fence in left field.
That's right.
So he had a fence in right field, and that's why Mike always went the opposite way. And that's a strikeout as Shoemaker goes down. So Wilczacki doing a nice job. Two quick outs.
Yeah, he's coming in, and this is the change, I think, Springford needs. That he comes over top, throws low. Might have been a little low, but again, I'm not the blue. Too close to take.
A generous call there on a breaking ball. Number 34, Ethan O'Donnell, the DH. Ball in the dirt. They are using a raised seam baseball, the Spalding. A big change. Remember, we used the Wilson A1010 when we coached. But it is different than a Major League Baseball. It's a raised seam ball. For the average fan out there, your curveball is going to get more action.
Yeah, more movement. Something more to grip.
There's a line drive center field, going to drop for a hit. Good swing by O'Donnell.
It's his third hit of the night.
As I mentioned earlier, Boyertown, the defending champion, Springford champion of 2 years ago. Number 35, Dylan Clark steps in. .458 on base percentage, 11 RBIs. Off and running. Safe at second base. O'Donnell showing good wheel.
Yeah, he is fast.
Clark did damage his last at bat, if I'm not mistaken.
He did. Bernie had a base hit. RBI knocked in their second run of the game. Nice shot down the line.
Wilczacki got two quick outs. Now he finds himself in a little bit of trouble. They have to keep it at 2-0 here. In the dirt. Romeo, the catcher for Springford, did a nice job blocking.
And pitchers there in that windup and comfortable with it. They look like, Warren Spahn, but sometimes when you have to throw that stretch, it changes things.
You are so dating yourself, man. The people out there, these millennials, they don't know who Warren Spahn
They're
is.
They're going to have to look it up.
Google it.
Google Warren Spahn. You'll be amazed at the numbers.
Ground ball hit hard right side. Nice play by Kratz. Over to Smiley for out number three. Take a break, 2-0, Phantoms on top.
So, car stories on PCTV. I've been doing it for many years. It's a good advertising tool for the business, plus I enjoy doing it. I enjoy sharing the shop and the different things that you should know about your car with people. If you need a place to highlight your business, call Gus at PCTV and check it out. It's a good way to inform people about your business. You'll get new customers from it, and you can share your knowledge of your particular trade.
Welcome back to Rams Stadium here in Royersford, Pennsylvania for the PAC Championship game. I'm Tyler Melton. I'm hopping into the booth here for an inning or so, joined by Richie Ashburn Jr., of course. Richie, it's an honor to be here with you.
Pleasure is mine.
Up first for Springford in the top of the fifth, Casella, the DH. First pitch was a strike. Swung on. Into deep left field. Got it. Diving play by the left fielder for Phoenixville. Nice jump on that one.
Yeah, he made a nice effort for that ball. This, he had to stretch out. Ball was fading away from him a little bit. We're getting a look here. Good swing. Hit it where it was pitched, unfortunately for him. Nice play by the left fielder.
Up next for Springford is Collins. He bunts. Third baseman makes a play on it. Throws the first in time. Two outs here for Springford quickly.
And that's what Springford's good at, bunting, and Phoenixville's very good at defending it. So it's nothing new for Phoenixville to see them bunt like this.
The new pitcher for Springford, Ben Wilczeki, number five, will come up to the plate, hoping to get Springford's second hit of the game. They haven't really been able to do anything offensively. Pitch swung on into left field in foul territory. Left fielder able to make the play, and that'll do it for the top of the fifth. Real quick one here. No runs, no hits, no errors. Springford still trails by two, going to the bottom of the fifth.
An orthopedic institute is more than a name. It's a unique care model based on quality and compassion. Decades devoted to research and clinical trials, the development of new surgical techniques, and physicians who outperform the field. What you get from our institute is more options and more answers. For your orthopedic care, think Rothman first.
New office and 7-day urgent care now open in Limerick.
Welcome back to Ram Stadium here in Royersford, Pennsylvania. Phoenixville up to bat this time. First pitch swung on into center field. Easy play. Quick one out here for Springford.
Well, your debut is going to be about a 3-minute long.
Yeah, that's kind of how it feels.
For a three-minute inning, you don't see many of those.
Now Blakey up to bat. The hero of last night's game. First pitch in the dirt. Ball one.
That's something he's going to remember for a long time.
Yeah, Phoenixville fighting back all night, really, last night, and able to walk that one off. What a great game for them. Second pitch in the dirt, this time swung on by Blakey. Count goes to 1-1. Swung on, fouled off, straight up. Takes the count to 1-2. This one just a bit outside, it looked like. So Blakey pulls the count to even. And while Springford may have struggled to get any hits, Phoenixville has not. They have seven already, along with their two-run lead here.
Yeah, they were swinging the bats. And Springford has done a nice job keeping it at 2-0, because this game could be about 6-0.
Yeah, the pitching staff has done a nice job working out of a couple of really tight situations. The base is loaded there in the third, and we're able to work out of it with only one run. I mean, really a nice job by Springford.
Yep.
Their pitching staff and defense, their offense just hasn't been able to do anything.
No, and that was a pivotal spot so far in this game.
Blakey steps in, swing and a miss, struck him out. Two gone here in the bottom of the fifth.
Well, Checky doing a nice job here, you know, keeping these hitters at bay, and he's out in front of that one. Nice change on that.
Brandon Fink stepping in, the left fielder. Little Checky sets, delivers. Low in the dirt, ball one. In there for strike one. Another one in the dirt. He's thrown a couple of those this inning so far.
Well, he came out last inning, the first two batters, and you know, right down, and then the third batter came up, and he's doing the same thing here. Trying to rush it a little bit, I think, trying to get out of this inning.
Count is 2-1 to Fink. The delivery swung on, fouled off.
Well, that must look like a good pitch because these guys are all – it's in the dirt when it gets to the plate. But
yeah, and Fink's smiling. He's going, you got me on that one. Let's see if he throws it again. Checky delivers. High ball three, full count here. Ken will Checky get a 1-2-3 here. Fink steps out. The delivery. Swung on, fouled straight back. So we'll reset and do it again.
Happens a lot in baseball.
Yes, it does.
Beautiful night for this.
It really is. It was a gorgeous night. A lot of rain earlier this week. Postponed this game twice. And a walk to Fink by Will Checky. And so we got a really nice night for this after the rain earlier this week.
Well, Bernie was talking about earlier the you know how the conditions on this field. I mean, after the rains we've been getting, it doesn't look like. I mean, it looks like it's been rained on, but it's not wet.
Gramer stepping in. Well, Checky checks over first. The throw over, not in time, safe. Fink taking a decent lead, but not a large lead. Again, the throw over, not in time. The delivery low to Grammer, ball one.
He seems to be a little different pitcher when he's out of the stretch. Not as, and the strikes are there, but he seems to be a little lower, a little off. Some pitchers are that way, out of the windup.
Another throw over again. Can't get Fink at first. Checky delivers low, ball two. And he's now thrown over to first three times already. Is that because he's trying to hold him at first for real, or is he trying to figure out how he wants to pitch? You said he's a little bit different out of the stretch, so is he maybe trying to not have to throw out of the stretch here?
He could be. I think he's worried too much about the runner. He's, you know, he put him in scoring position. They're already down 2-0. He just needs to worry about the batter.
Yeah, especially because now the count is 3-0. To Grammer. The delivery from Will Checky. In there for strike one.
I wouldn't be surprised he takes another one.
Yeah. Sets, delivers, swung on, chopped foul.
Hey, he's up there hacking.
Full count. And let's see if Will Checky can work out of this without getting a runner into scoring position. Or worse.
Yeah, he's fighting out there, but doing the job so far.
Yeah, sets, delivers. Runner goes from first. Swung on and a foul ball.
That's a good pitch right there, right on the hands, but it was a strike.
Check, he throws over, almost got him, but not quite.
Not a bad move for a righty. He's not taking big leads right now either.
No, he's not. Another throw over. That's the fifth throw over in this inning by Wilczeki.
Of course, even though they're the visiting team, they won't get booed.
Right. The delivery in the dirt, ball four. He's walked two straight, and now Fink will advance into scoring position.
Yeah, Springford's had a little trouble with the bottom of the lineup here tonight. They're not scoring the runs, but there's four or five walks, a hit by pitch, and these guys are getting on base at the bottom of the lineup. So top of the lineup needs to do a little bit more, but Phoenixville, like you said, they've been hitting a little bit, and this is where Springford needs to shut him down to stay in this game.
Justin Geiger up to bat, and now a conversation out on the mound. That might be it for Wilczeki, as now we have a couple of guys now running to the bullpen.
It probably will give him this batter at least. I don't think they have anybody warmed up quite yet, but he's pitched well enough to deserve another batter, that's for sure. I know coaches, though, that after two straight walks, he still wouldn't be out there.
Yeah.
But this is, this is a kid you want out there.
Well, to your point, I think you can't worry about the runners on the bases,
right,
and just, you have two outs. So either get this guy into a grounder or get him out at the plate.
Right. Of course, that's as I pitched a little bit, too, and I was always told, you just got to think ground balls. And,
yep,
and the more you do that, the better things are. The more your fielders like you, too, because they get a ball.
And so Geiger steps in. Runners on first and second for Phoenixville. The delivery from Wilczeki, swung on into right field. Routine play, and that'll do it for the fifth. So Wilczeki is able to work out of that one. No runs, no hits, no errors. Two men left on for Phoenixville. They still lead 2-0.
The beautiful historic Redding Country Club, now open to the public. Play the same course that Sneed, Hogan, and Hagen played. Designed back in 1923 by renowned golf architect Alex Finlay, the Redding has 18 championship holes. Now, after your round, just stop on by the Patio Grill for delicious food and a nice ice-cold beverage. Why not book your organization's next outing at the Redding Country Club? Hey, and by the way, check out the weekly exciting leagues. It's memorable now at the Redding. For more information, just check out the website, reddingccgolf.com.
One day these rats were playing in the woods.
One of some wretches and that's no good.
Yeah. So the gorgeous forest is what you decide. Don't play with matches. Don't play with fire.
Only you can prevent forest fires.
Fire!
We are back in the 2019 championship for the Pioneer Athletic Conference. Springford, Rich, down to their final six outs.
Yeah, and they got to do something with it. They're lucky to still be in this game. It could be about 9-0 right now, Phoenixville. But Springford's, has...
Simmons rips a shot to deep right center. Off the wall! It'll be extra bases. He's going to go all the way to third base with a stand-up triple. They thought about inside the park. Oh, man. But considering the score, you just can't do that.
Can't do it. Runner at third base now. Nobody out. Beautiful. Beautiful swing here. Looker hit it where it's pitched and really drove it. Thought the center fielder actually had a chance at it, but it just sailed over his head, bounced up to the wall. Great hit. And Slipping still making the play. Lucky they stayed down, they would have scored.
Good wheels by Simmons. Number seven, the senior center fielder, Chase Simmons. 311 hitter, 397 on base percentage, having a conference out at the mound. Again, both these teams with stellar regular seasons. The regular season, a real predicament at the end. Methacton 12-4, the best record in the league. Four teams tied at 11-5. Springford and Boyertown, along with O&J and Phoenixville. The tiebreaker that put Boyertown on the outside looking in, divisional record. There's a ball ripped to left center. Base hit in the ramps. They're on the board. Mark McNelly with a good stroke.
Big RBI. Another great swing here. That's two batters in a row. They're hitting it where it's pitched and right where it's pitched. Nice job by Springford. They're right back in the game.
We'll take a break. We've got a pitching change. A tight 2-1 ball game.
Welcome to the beautiful historic Redding Country Club, now open to the public. Play the same course that Sneed, Hogan, and Hagen played. Designed back in 1923 by renowned golf architect Alex Finlay, the Redding has 18 championship holes. Now, after your round, just stop on by the Patio Grill for delicious food and a nice ice-cold beverage. Why not book your organization's next outing at the Redding Country Club? Hey, and by the way, check out the weekly exciting leagues. It's memorable now at the Redding. For more information, just check out the website, reddingccgolf.com.
We are back, and the drama is unfolding. A new pitcher, number 39, Jason Bilotti, for Phoenixville on the mound, a big right-hander. And the dangerous top four on the Springford lineup, Mark McNelly, number two, the senior shortstop, 311 average, and a 391 on base percentage. All right, sorry, that's David McCurry. The four-hitter, number six, senior, left fielder, David McCurry. Two doubles and a triple on the season, 10 RBIs, 9 runs scored. Nobody out. Rich, to go-ahead run at the plate.
Springford did a great job staying in this game. It could be ugly, but they're battling right now, and Phoenixville's got some pressure on them. New pitcher.
Off and running. Throw down to second base. Easily in with a head first slide. Ricky Henderson style.
I watched him come off of first base, and he's looking at the catcher. I don't know if you can see it here, but you can't. He is looking at the catcher. I'm like, that's not what you're supposed to do. He beat that easily. Kid's got some speed.
See, I'm dating myself now. These millennials will be Googling, who's Ricky Henderson?
Well, that's a little more modern time than Warren Spahn.
There's a ball ripped to right field. Way back near the wall. Off the wall. It's going to score the run. McMurray into second with a stand-up double.
And just like that. Bernie, I'm seeing some exceptional swings here tonight from both sides. We're getting this look here. That is beautiful. And he drove that ball. It was almost out of this ballpark.
I thought it may have been out of here.
I would have loved to heard out of here.
Hunter Curley will step up to the plate. Runner in scoring position, nobody out. They're going to bunt. Ball in the dirt. Are you surprised they're bunting here? Your dad would not like this.
No, he wouldn't. They got nobody out, though, that runner at third. I understand why he's doing it. And he's going to get it done, so.
Well done by Hunter Curley. The five-hole hitter, whose RBI triple, he was the offensive star just 24 hours ago. He's asked to bunt. It is successful. Sacrifice bunt, only one out. The go-ahead run at third base.
This is what they wanted. You know, three straight hits, a bunt. They might be taking the lead.
Jason Smiley, big night again last night in the semifinal. At the dish, number eight, senior first baseman. They're going to bunt. Infield's in. He's going to get the run in. A safety squeeze. The forgotten art.
That is a forgotten art. And a gutsy move here by Coach Jack. They're going to bunt. I mean, this is a team beautiful. Put it right where he's supposed to.
What do you think, Rich? If he fires home immediately, it's a bang-bang play.
I don't know if it is bang-bang. It would have been close, but that's where you make more mistakes. They probably were smart to get the out.
Zach Kratz steps up in the batter's box. Junior second baseman. Two outs. But just like that, the Rams with a three spot in the top of the sixth. That has ignited this crowd.
Visiting team has its advantages, Burns.
Mm-hmm. The Rams are the visiting team on the scoreboard despite playing in their home stadium. The sun has gone down. The lights illuminating nicely.
Moon's out. Beautiful night for baseball, Burns. Right straight ahead of you.
Oh, there you go. Hey, there's our picture in picture. Thanks to marvelous Matt Wagner.
The technology today.
We're having fun. We got a big crew out here having a good time. We had the cheese melt sandwiches before the game. And that is strike three. That'll end the inning. But a three spot in the top of the sixth.
Limerick Bowl is the area.
Rams on top, 3-2.
Limerick Bowl is the area's ultimate family entertainment center. Your league bowling headquarters for all ages and all abilities. Come in anytime and enjoy daily specials or experience our weekend glow bowling. Celebrate your next birthday at Limerick Bowl with the area's most affordable party packages. Now including our newly renovated Family Fun Arcade. Limerick Bowl on West Ridge Pike. Get more information about upcoming leagues, tournaments, and open bowling specials online at limerickbowl.com.
We go to the bottom of the sixth. The Phoenixville Phantoms find themselves down by a score of 3-2. Colton Brown, the leadoff hitter, at the plate. Steve Reich. As I mentioned earlier, both these teams already qualified for the playoff. Springford is the 15 seed, which will get them an away game more than likely in the 6A playoff. And Phoenixville is the number 5 seed at 5A, so they'll get a home game.
Well, I'll tell you, they're both scrappy teams and fun to watch them.
Foul ball to the right side. 10 teams out of 12 have qualified for the playoffs.
Wow.
So congratulations to Methacton, O&J, Boyertown, Perk Valley, Pottsgrove with a great season thus far, Upper Perk, Pope John Paul, and Pottstown have also qualified for the playoff. There's a ground ball right back to the pitcher. He knocks it down, fires to first, gets him in time.
Nice play, stayed with it. Young man's doing a job, kept his team in the game. Takes one, I don't know where it hit him. Oh, right off the glove. Back of the hand there, nice play. Way to stay with that. Big out.
Number 22, Shoemaker at the plate. finish that earlier thought. We had an exciting no-hitter about 10 days ago. Congratulations, Gusevich out of Boyertown with the no-no. There's a ball ripped to right field. Back near the track. Off the wall to the extra bases. Shoemaker rolls into third. A bullet of a throw. It gets by, but it'll stay at third. A clutch hit by Shoemaker.
Well, he was 0 for 3 until this moment. He crushed that ball to right center. Nearly knocked it out of this park. Tied the ball game. Phoenixville now threatening to tie this game.
One out. The tying run is 90 feet away. Ethan O'Donnell, the DH, number 34. The infield is in. The championship is on the line. Rich, are you surprised he's going full windup?
No, he's on third, and I think he pitches better in the windup, Byrne. Just the evaluations I've made of him the last couple innings. In the stretch, he seems to not be the pitcher he is on the mound. You know what I mean? It takes a little off his pitch. It's definitely a different pitcher when there's men on base.
There is bullpen activity for the Rams. Ooh, umps love when you show them up like that.
Yeah, the next one. Next one goes to the pitcher if it's close.
That strike zone got a lot bigger. Ball four. That sets up the precarious and always interesting, Rich, first and third situation.
Yeah.
What do you do here? You make get inside the mind of the coaches.
Well, you got a good hitter up there, first and third. Now, he's not a fast runner, ground ball. You probably got a double play. I don't like taking bats out of anybody's hands. You know, these kids bring you a long way by swinging the bat. So as a...
Hey, please take a look at our screen, our crew that we never take for granted. Our boss, Gus Constantine Tellis, calling the shots in the truck. The assistant director, Bucktown's own Matt Wagner. The marvelous Matt Wagner. Carly Tellis, home from college, doing a stellar job on graphics. Diamond Dave Oxenford on camera. The lovely Olivia Prothro on camera.
Olivia should get hazard duty. Tonight.
And my fave, Debbie Tellis, out there in center field. Up on that van in the, they better check. There's animals, critters out there running around. There you can see the center field shot from Debbie Tellis. Robert Keller, always clutch for the PCTV network.
He pitched too high, and then they were like, oh, and then some girl said, be quiet.
Leonard, number 15, right-hander in for Springford. Production, Justin Panner doing a fantastic job. What a great crew we had tonight. And Tyler Melton out of Ohio State on production. I'm a Penn State guy. I don't like Ohio State. Well, now, you're a Nebraska guy.
I'm a Nebraska guy.
So let me ask you, you love all the Philadelphia sports teams,
sure.
Right? But if Nebraska's playing Penn State for the national championship in college football, who are you rooting for?
Big Red.
Oh, you're killing me. You're killing me.
I can't go away from my roots.
You know,
they're my roots.
I looked at Tilden, Nebraska on the map. It's cold out there.
Oh, yeah.
Man,
yeah,
I didn't realize how far north. You're near the Dakotas.
They're south. Yeah, South Dakota.
You're not far from Minnesota.
You're right. No, you're right.
I'm thinking, well, I didn't know much about it.
They were just dealing with some awful flooding.
Oh, my God.
Historic flooding. And my mom can tell you some historic things out there, but it was bad.
Dylan Clark with a chance to tie the championship game up. Runners on first and third, one out. A faked stolen base. Try to draw a throw. Leonard, the right-hander for the Rams on the mound. Good velocity, but out of the zone. I'm liking the longer hair on Leonard, kind of that Marty Bystrom 70s, 80s look, you know?
Yeah, or Syndergaard these days, right?
Wait, can you tell me?
A lot of guys grow that long hair.
Wait, how do you tell? Oh, runs.
Gets a high strike. Wow.
That's a tough pitch to hit.
Clark doesn't right like that. Woody, I call the strike zone letters to, belt. Actually, belt to knees.
Right.
I'm old school. Belt to knees. That was way above the belt.
Well, it used to be letters to knees. But,
yeah.
But that
bottom changed. Of the letters.
Yeah, bottom of the letters.
Depending on where your letters were.
I always told Coach to put my letters right above my belt.
You know, the National League for years was belt to knees, low. The American League, the umps used to work over the top with the shield, so their strike zone was higher.
Yeah.
Walk. Good eye by Clark. Bases are loaded. One out. The drama unfolding. It is the championship of the Pioneer Athletic Conference. Devin Gorrell, the senior second baseman, 300 hitter, 11 RBI, 10 runs scored. He just needs to put the ball in play somewhere.
Put it in play. Obviously, he doesn't want to hit it right at anybody because they'll probably go home with it.
Are you surprised that they're not playing infield? A balk is going to bring in the tying run. Oh, my.
We're gonna get to look at this. He's set. I'm not seeing any movement. I don't know what I saw there, Bernie. I didn't see anything.
Right at the beginning when Gus queued it up, there was a little shuffle. It was subtle, but I think it's the correct call. And I think he knew it too. He seemed
he's
a little
not arguing.
Yeah, he's not arguing. He seems a little seemed a little out of rhythm.
Tough way to let the game be tied up.
We're all tied. Ball in the dirt. They're going to go for it. There's a play at the plate in Phoenixville. We'll get the go-ahead run.
Wow, pitch.
The Phantom contingency is roaring on the other side of the stadium.
Two tough pitches in a row here for this young man. The balk and then a wild pitch. And now you find yourself down a run. It's not what he was envisioning, I'm sure, Bernie.
The big guy, Clark, on third base with one out, 90 feet away from an insurance run. Infielder's in. Swinging a ball fouled straight back.
Good cut. They got a one-run lead. Phoenixville would love this man on third at home.
Boy, we've called some great games in this stadium. This one is unfolding as a heart thumper line shot. Center field, it's down. An insurance run crosses.
Right down the middle and put right back up the middle.
And the Rams are going to make a pitching change. We'll take a break. Phantoms on top, 5-3. Yakalak Construction, serving the Tri-County area since 1946. Family owned, free estimates. All types of concrete work, sidewalks, foundations, steps, curbs, and more. Professional service and quality. Give them a call, 610-323-8134.
There's a place for wood in your backyard. We recommend the fire pit. For looks and performance that outlast a wooden deck, make sure your next deck is built with Trex. Engineering what's next in outdoor living.
Your Trex expert is A.D. Moyer Lumber. ADMoyer.com.
At Superior Credit Union, we believe in growing stronger together. So we provide products and services to fit your financial needs and accommodate your busy lifestyle. With convenient services like home banking, e-deposits, account alerts, and a free coin counter for members, come see why Superior Credit Union is growing. Visit any one of our three locations in Collegeville, Royers Ford, and our brand new location in Pottstown. Superior Credit Union.
We are back. The score is 5-3, Phoenixville on top over Springfort. It is the 2019 championship. The dangerous Justin Blakey is at the plate. Runner on first, one out. Breaking ball in the dirt. First base is occupied, so the runner is out. That'll be two outs. Number 18 on the mound, Cooper Webb. Very fine athlete for the Rams. Richard, we at the PCTV Network family would like to extend our condolences over the loss of your father-in-law, Keith Taylor, Hacksaw as we knew him. Yeah. What a great guy, and he will be sorely missed.
Yes, he will. One of the most wonderful people I've ever known in my life, Bernie, and I appreciate that. My wife would really appreciate it.
I love going out to the farmhouse, see him sit there with the remote watching the Phillies.
He was a huge Phillies fan and really my second father in life. I spent a lot of time with him in late years with him. Wonderful, wonderful man.
Every time I went down the batting cages, he always had a smile on his face.
He helped me down there quite a bit.
You know, I would think of him in the same sense of David Montgomery, the Phillies chairman who we lost recently.
Yeah.
A very similar type of person.
Both very caring, loving individuals. You never know that my father-in-law, now his nickname was Hacksaw. It didn't really fit him. He was a 4th Marine Division. We'll get back to it.
Strike three, and that minimizes the damage. The Rams are down to their final three outs.
When did you see the sign?
When I needed to jumpstart sales.
Build attendance for an event.
Help people find their way. Fast Signs designed new directional signage.
And got them back on track. Get started at fastsigns.com.
Welcome back. The Springfort Rams are down to the final three outs of their PAC season. The championship is on the line. Phoenixville in purple, in command. Putting three runs on the board in the bottom of the sixth. I did my seventh inning stretch a little ahead of time. You have to stretch when you're old. That's one thing I never liked about amateur baseball. You don't get a true seventh inning stretch, you know, if the home team wins.
Right.
But number 25 at the plate for the Rams. And that is a sophomore DH, Jack Casella. He's had to have been called up from JVs. His stats on the year, two at-bats, one hit. Swing and a miss, strike three, first out. Phantom Nation can taste it over there.
Gets a good look at a righty right down the middle here. A little bit under it.
Pitching ahead in the count. Number number 39, Jason Bilotti, looking to close out the title game. Rich, you still doing home run for Hearts this year?
I did. I bunted. I have an injury to my foot. I can't
swing. Strike three, looking. Out number two. The Phantom fans are on their feet.
These young hitters. That you can't look at that. Way too close. Hopefully they learn from it as they go down playing later in the year, in districts or even next year.
The only thing that's a little precarious here, that turns the lineup over, and the dangerous Wilczacki. The next four hitters are just terrific hitters. So.
Yeah, they won't quit, I guarantee it.
This game is not over. One of the better games we've seen down here. We've seen some good ones. Ronnie Civic's walk-off was a classic in 2010. Best game I ever did, I think, for the network in 16 years was 2012 district championship. Phoenixville was losing 7-1 in the sixth inning. They come back on the PCTV network and win the district title with Ashburn, Jack Ashburn, right?
Yes.
To win the district championship. Yes. Here we go, one strike away. Fly ball deep to left field, way back, near the wall. Off the wall, extra bases. Wilczacki buried it.
Good swing that ball was carrying. He's probably praying for just a little bit of wind. Good hitting right off that back foot, good swing. I thought it was gone, Byrne.
Yeah, it's cooled down a little bit. Oh,
very
man.
Close.
That was almost.
Yep.
See you later. Home run. You know, the humidity has something to do with that. It's only 33% humidity. When you get humidity up in the 70s, you get an extra 10 feet out of that.
Oh, yeah. Low humidity tonight.
Yeah.
Definitely cooled down even more.
On a summer night, that baby's 20 feet out of here. They're going to get a pitching change. No, we're going to stay with the right-hander. But that brings the tying run to the plate. And a guy that you don't want at the plate, Chase Simmons, one of the top players in the conference.
Yeah, he tripled his last at-bat, one of the nicest at-bats of the evening. He's looking for a hit. Try to keep this thing going.
Jason Bilotti, the sophomore, on the mound. Good low strike. Phoenixville not even worried about the runner on second. Just outside. Simmons with a good eye.
Got to have a good eye in this moment.
Very entertaining baseball game, especially considering what's at stake, the conference championship. Fouled straight back. One strike away from Phantom Nation, celebrating in Ram Nation.
That's correct.
Two school districts that border each other. Kick and the pitch. Strike three, it's over. Phoenixville wins the title. 2019 champions of the Pioneer Athletic Conference, the Phoenixville Phantoms. The final score, 5-3 over Springford. Don't go away, we'll be right back to wrap this baby up.
For more than 50 years, Pottstown Oral and Maxillofacial Surgery has served its community with expert dental care, offering patients dental implants and a full menu of procedures for many types of dental problems, including bone grafting, wisdom teeth, impacted canines, facial trauma, jaw surgery, oral pathology, TMJ disorders, and sleep apnea. Get the smile you've always wanted. Contact Pottstown Oral and Maxillofacial Surgery today.
Hey, welcome back, everyone. We have a new champion by a score of 5-3, the Phoenixville Phantoms, the 2019 champs for the Pioneer Athletic Conference. I'm with our color commentator, Richie Ashburn Jr., and Dave Semina. Congratulations, champions of the conference. Coach Ashburn has a few questions for you.
Okay. Well, I was just asking you, Coach, that you had to be nervous in there, and you came back and told me you were as calm as could be. Now, I was probably more nervous than you were, but... What a great job.
We've come back two nights in a row now, and this team's done it all year. So it's been like a dream that way with this group. They battle, and they don't stop. They don't quit.
Well, I saw that tonight, yeah. and it was a pleasure to watch. Now, your first pitcher, Kingsbury.
Freshman.
What a job.
It was beyond belief. I mean, I was ready to – I had pitchers warming up in the first inning, second inning, and then he was on a roll, and I had to leave him in. I couldn't, you know. My coaches were telling me to take him out.
You made the right decision.
I did.
He did a nice job, especially such a young kid like that.
Yeah.
And the game was so back and forth. I mean, you guys had control of this game. I thought maybe you should have been up 7-8-0 at one point. You might have thought the same thing.
Absolutely.
And Springford kept fighting back.
Yep.
Took
yep.
the lead.
Yep.
Your guys didn't falter one bit.
No.
And the pitcher you brought in, Bilotti, did an amazing job.
He did. And he's a sophomore. So there's another young pitcher, right? Our catcher's a sophomore. So, I mean, they're young kids that are you know, producing for this.
Congratulations. And you guys did a brilliant job this year. You did a brilliant job this year.
Thank you.
I look forward to seeing you down the road. And good luck in the playoffs.
You. Thank you. Thank you, Rich.
Dave Semina, congratulations. Good luck in district playoffs.
Thank you.
All right.
Thanks,
Rich. All right. While there's a little bit of sadness on the Springford side in this stadium, there is happiness in Ram Nation just over the hill. I just found out from Mickey McDaniel. Congratulations. The Springford Ram softball team, one of the top teams in the state, raised their record to 21-0. They defeated Methacton, and they are the champions of the conference 2019. Let's talk a little bit about Ram baseball, Richie. The top four in that lineup, the multiple opportunities to put runs on the board, a tremendous coaching staff led by Jamie Sheck came up a little short tonight.
They did, and they fought hard. I mean, they were down 2-0. Like I said, it could have been 7-8-0, something like that, and they stayed in the game, took the lead late in the game, looked like it was going to be another Springford, you know, comeback for a win, and give credit to Phoenixville. They hung in there against a very tough team. I wish both of these guys luck in the districts and beyond, because they're both that good.
And how challenging is it for Coach Sheck and Springford? They lose their ace, Skoraki, so it's next man up from here on in for the rest of the season.
Yeah, and a good learning experience for the guys that had to step up. You know, you're thrown into the championship game, and you got to try to perform. They'll learn from it. The coaches here will always make sure these kids learn from it. It's a great job by this staff. And they just came up a little short tonight.
And then finally, on the up note, Phoenixville, the champions. We saw the hero of last night's game, Blakey, with a big rip tonight. And Bilotti, the sophomore, comes in to close the door.
Yeah, he comes in as a sophomore, freshman. I'm hearing sophomore, freshman. It's amazing. And Phoenixville's, they've got a great coach with this guy. I'd like to see him back. That's not my decision, but... you know, when a guy comes out here with nerves of steel in that situation, you got to like him.
So we have 10 teams in the postseason. Good luck to all 10 teams in the district and hopefully state playoffs. For Richie Ashburn Jr., I'm Bernie Gallagher, and our entire hardworking PCTV Network crew, thanks for watching. That's a wrap. We are out.